joining me this morning is Pharmaxis CEO Gary Phillips. Good to have you here, Gary.
Good morning, Alicia.
Gary, Pharmaxis has announced today that global device developer Aptar has agreed to pay you US$5 million to acquire an inhaler technology from you. Give us the background on this. Where did this agreement come from and why does Aptar want this technology?
Sure, yeah. No, it's, Pharmaxis is an expert in small molecule drug discovery and clinical development. So for us this morning to be announcing a deal on an inhaler device is a little bit left field, I guess, for many people. But the origins of this go back to our cystic fibrosis drug, Bronchitol. And that drug, when we developed it, it's got a dose of 400 milligrams of dry powder that is delivered to the lungs. And that's delivered through a device and 10 capsules at a time. So each capsule contains 40 milligrams. Now, that's a real outlier in respiratory drugs. A lot of drugs for asthma and COPD, you deliver micrograms of powder at a time. So 400 milligrams is a huge amount. So when we were looking around for a better device and a way of improving the patient experience as a line of life extension and extending the patent on the drug, we were looking for an inhaler which could handle such a high payload of dry powder. And to be honest, there was nothing around. There was nothing that fit that. And I came across some intellectual property in the UK, which did seem to fit the bill, but was really at a very early stage. It hadn't really been developed in anything like a commercial fashion. So we acquired that. This is more than 10 years ago. And we worked with a specialist engineering company, again in the UK, to develop it, the product to a prototype stage. So what we've actually got, the Orbital, is actually a device which contains a large container, what we call a puck, that can contain the full 400 milligrams. And then the patient takes multiple breaths from that inhaler without having to change the capsule or the puck that's there. So it becomes a bit like a dry powder nebulizer. You know, people are used to having a liquid and they put a mask on and they take multiple breaths without having to change it. Well, this is the same thing, but in a very small, sometimes reusable device that you can take multiple breaths from. So it's unique. So when Aptar, a global device company, came along and they were also looking for a solution to this particular niche that nobody else had filled, and they found us, it looked like a great opportunity both for them and for us. So so their interest in us came from, you know, there's a clear market need for a high payload device.
Gary, can we dig a little bit more into the fine print of this agreement with Aptar?
Yeah, so when we started talking to them, would have been over a year ago. And you know, there's a lot of diligence to do on this kind of technology. They were clearly very interested, but wanted to take a longer look at it. So 12 months ago, we signed an option deal with them, and that option gave them 12 months to look at the technology, both from a technical perspective and a commercial perspective. And then within that 12 months, they could exercise an option. Now, the option number one was it would cost them $2.5 million in order to take a global license to the technology. And that would have then meant, after acquiring the license, that they would have paid us royalties on any sales they made on the product for a certain period of time after the deal was signed. But there was also a second option within the agreement, which allowed them to do an outright acquisition of the technology for a further $2.5 million. So the announcement that we made yesterday was that they've decided to take up both options. So therefore, they pay us immediately a sum of $5 million, which equates to around about just over 7 million Australian dollars for an outright acquisition of the technology. Within that, though, we still retain the rights for delivering our product, mannitol, which is the active substance in Bronchitol, through the Orbital device in a royalty free agreement that will go back the other way. So we've kind of protected our long term rights for our product, but at the same time, the deal allows us to get some benefit from the wider opportunity that there is for a high payload device.
All right, so Gary, $5 million on the table as the result of this deal. How significant is this cash injection to Pharmaxis at this time?
It's really significant. I'm sure you and other people watching this will know that the global financial markets at the moment are perhaps at one of the lowest spots that they've been in terms of access to cash. So all of us in the biotech sphere are being, you know, very cautious with cash. And therefore, you know, are we finished June with a pro forma 14 million cash in the bank? So this is, about, you know, 7.2 million Australian dollars comes from this deal. So, it, you know, it's going from 14 to up to 21 pro forma is a very significant increase in cash. And as I said, non-dilutive cash of this type for our shareholders at this particular time when the global markets are struggling is really, so you can't put a value on it. It's $7 million, but, you know, it's I think it's got a more than that given the conditions there are at the moment.
All right. So with that cash in hand and looking towards the end of the year, which is fast approaching now, what are the key milestones that Pharmaxis wants to touch on before year's end?
Well, we started with the interview with me referencing our talents as a small molecule drug developer. And we've got two drugs which are in phase two studies. The first one is PXS5505. It's an antifibrotic and it's being trialed in a phase two study of myelofibrosis, which is a rare kind of bone marrow cancer. That's been tough to recruit. It's an orphan disease, but we are making good headway now, and we expect to have some good data from that study by the end of the year. Now, that's a transformational study for that drug and for the company. The myelofibrosis as an opportunity is $1 billion a year market. And this is a clinical proof of concept study. We're expecting to see safety, but also we're hoping to see some signs of efficacy from the trial as well. So that's due by, you know, we hope to get a substantial data update that we can release to the market by the end of the year. So we're looking forward to that. The other study is being is with Professor Fiona Wood over in Perth. In scarring, and we have a topical antifibrotic drug, so it's applied to the skin in a cream, and that's being used in patients who've got established scars, so scars that have been on their skin for more than a year. And that, again, we've already looked at the first few patients coming out of that, and I think we're really pleased with the progress we're making to date. That study is recruiting really, really quite quickly now. And again, we expect to have data from that study to release to the market by the end of the year. And again, hoping to see both safety and some efficacy signals coming out of that. So again, either one of those is a transformational readout for the company, and all of them happening within the next 6 months. So it's a pretty exciting time for the company and its shareholders at the moment.
Pharmaxis CEO Gary Phillips, thanks for your time and the update. We look forward to hearing more from you shortly.
Thank you very much. Look forward to it too.